This Civic Media podcast is sponsored by UW Organ and Tissue Donation. Organ donations are desperately needed, and now is the right time to become an organ donor. Talk to your family. Get the dot. Save lives. Go to heroicdeed.com.
Live from the Civic Media World Headquarters in Madison, Wisconsin, it's the Todd Albaugh Show. And now, pursuing truth wherever it may lead, here's your host, Todd Albaugh.
Across Wisconsin on the Civic Media Radio Network and streaming worldwide on the Civic Media app. Good afternoon, everybody. I'm Todd Albaugh, along with Mr. Aaron Zommers on the board. It is 6 minutes past the hour of 12 noon on this Wednesday, November 27th, 2024. It is a great day to be a Wisconsinite on Thanksgiving Eve, and it is
Hump Day!
Even the camel made it from Thanksgiving dinner a month early. Normally, the camel would show up for the nativity, but here he is.
Yeah, there's back in Manitowoc, in my hometown, there was somebody... couple of blocks over from me who had this giant like 10-foot tall camel statue in their yard year round and decorated it differently for the seasons. And so they gave it a little like turkey feathers and stuff for their Thanksgiving.
A festive camel.
Very festive camel.
All right, very good.
There's an origin story in there somewhere.
You hear his voice every morning from 6 until 8. You hear him now dressed in his appropriate pilgrim costume on the shores of Lake Wissota. There he is, host of Up North News Radio. Mr. Pat Kreitlow joins us. And from our nation's capital, there in Washington, D.C., former Republican like myself, a River Falls native, and now a senior advisor at the Lincoln Project, Mr. Trygve Olson. Patrick Trygve, welcome and happy Thanksgiving.
Hey, if I'm going to be dressed up as a pilgrim, then I insist that Trygve looks more like Paul Simon on Saturday Night Live in that turkey outfit.
Wouldn't that be great? Yeah. Wouldn't that be great? How are you guys?
Oh, ready. Right. Ready for a long weekend, ready for a holiday, ready for all the conversations that are going to happen with family over the coming days.
Well, interesting you talk about that, Pat, because Trygve and I are going to talk about that a little bit in through the show here. And I think you bring up a good point, which is I'm fortunate because the people that I'm spending Thanksgiving with, we're all on the same side of the political spectrum of the election from 3 weeks ago. So there might be some lamenting, a little bit of drinking, but there won't be any fighting. But I know for a lot of folks, that is just not the case. And I know there's a lot of people who are really have a lot of anxiety about this weekend. And some people are just staying home.
And I can't say that I blame them. I mean, yeah. I feel very fortunate that the couple of folks in my family that I have political disagreements with. Long ago, we reached a rather silent understanding that, you know, we just don't bring those things up. And if somebody does, the other person tends not to take the bait. Right. And I understand that I'm fortunate that way, unlike in other families. And I have to say that given what I'm seeing, and I don't mean to sound like a card-carrying member of the Lincoln Project here, but the stakes are different. These aren't typical disagreements. Mm-hmm. And so when folks do get a little upset about the hijacking of democracy and what's going to happen to people moving forward, I urge everybody to count to 10 first, but I'm not going to assess a lot of blame like I would in years past where I'd be like, oh, it's just Thanksgiving. Let the politics go for one day. It right. does feel a little more personal now.
Yeah. Trygve, we're going to talk about this more in detail in the show. You actually have a friend of yours who's done some real work on this, and Kira Sabin, who's been on this show, who is a positivity psychologist, a life coach, has had a lot of training on these things. In fact, we're going to replay one of her interviews from a couple of years ago. Is it tomorrow, Zommers, we're replaying
That's
this?
Tomorrow. Yeah, tomorrow? It's actually from the very first Todd Albaugh show.
From the very first show. I can't believe it was from the first show.
God. That'll explain a lot.
Yeah. Right? But Kira talked about, and just a couple of quick things, one of the things she talks about, look, if it really is just way too mentally and gets into a physical stress for you, it's okay to say, look, I love you, but I think it's just better we take a break this holiday and don't go. I mean, there's nothing wrong with that necessarily. But number two, she's talked about kind of setting parameters before you get there and say, look, I love you. All right. We have some disagreements. Can we agree that we're not going to talk about whatever subject? In this case, we're just not going to talk about the election. We could talk about the Packers. We could talk about the dinner table. We could talk about, you know, whatever you want to. But we're just going to have that be the one subject that we're not. You could kind of set parameters before you go, Trygve.
Yeah, you can't do that if you have Viking fans at your.
No, you got to draw the line someplace. Quite honestly. Without a doubt. I mean, come on.
That is a lifestyle choice that, yes, honestly, no one should make.
Yeah, I'm happy to judge there.
Right.
So, I mean, it's one thing to be a Lions fan or a Bears fan. They're proud franchises. They're not, you know, and they don't wear purple.
Yeah, go ahead.
Yeah, I mean, there is nothing wrong with that. I think the, you know, Thanksgiving dinner should not turn into crossfire, right? So if you have somebody
the
who
McLaughlin
is
group.
is spouting the talking points, or you know, has hubris about where they are and whatnot, you know, the best strategy is A, you can create some separation, and B, if you can't, is to really just try and ask questions and think about who they are and how they see themselves in other parts of their life and ask questions as it that basically get to the incongruence between what they're espousing politically and standing for and what they're backing politically. And you may not win, you're not going to win an argument, but you may plant some seeds down the line that you will be able to use. You have to understand you're not going to switch somebody's opinion at Thanksgiving dinner.
I think that's a great point to make. It's just not going, you're not going to transform anybody at Thanksgiving. And Pat, I also think there's, especially if you're going to someone else's house, or I guess even if you're not, you know, think about the other people there. This right. isn't your opportunity to, as Trygve just said, to win an argument. Think about the person or the people that went to all the work to fix the dinner over the last, you know, however long they've worked hard for, have got their home ready. And they didn't do this to, as Trygve said, turn it into crossfire or a Sunday morning talk show. And just, I don't know, maybe it's just me, but take a breath, swallow hard, and just say, how about that cranberry sauce? You know, I don't know. That's, you know.
Yeah. Or in some other way, detach the politics from it, which is to say, for example, when, you know, when your brother-in-law, you know, starts coming at you right away, is to say, tell you what, how about if we just pick that up at, you know, 5 o'clock,
right?
You know, we're right after, you know, whatever football game ends, and let's just, you know, do everything else. And then when that comes, we'll talk. Or why don't we go to coffee next week and right. we can talk more about it and not have to bother all these fine folks here who really don't want to get into it.
Yeah.
Let's talk about it after the Packer game, since yes. they play at 7 o'clock. So by that time,
somebody's yeah. passed out for whatever reason. You know?
For whatever reason it might be. And look, I can hear people saying, "Well, what are you diminishing your own values? Don't you have strong opinions?" Yes, I really do. I don't care any less, but I also know that I'm not willing to die on the hill of blowing up Thanksgiving dinner with my family.
Right.
I can take my very strong personal views and I can actually compartmentalize them long enough to enjoy everything else about this person that I love, except for their political values.
Yeah, totally agree.
And you can say, you know, at which we should all be thankful that we live where we live in, you know, I don't know where things are going to go starting in next year, but what I have suspicions. But the reality is we live in the most prosperous nation in the history of mankind. And for the moment, we still do. And that is something we should all be thankful for. We should think back to what is the original message of Thanksgiving. And quite frankly, I would argue that our politics have not been reflecting why the people got together on Plymouth Rock long ago. And so maybe Thanksgiving should be thought about as a reminder of what the message and the intention of the holiday is at its core.
I also think, I know Pat's watched Ted Lasso. Trygve, have you watched that series, Ted Lasso?
I have definitely watch Ted Lasso. Yeah. So I didn't watch the last season.
But well, I don't want to spoil it. I don't want to spoil it for people who maybe haven't come to the series yet. But I've been protracting the third season because I just didn't want it to come to an end. And and last night I watched the series finale. And I will simply say this, and I want to just leave it at that, Pat. I don't want to, again, I want people to experience this themselves. But forgiveness is an amazing power. And I think that, you know, this is a great time of year that maybe people said some things during the election season. Maybe we said them to each other. And again, Pat, I think your point's so important. It doesn't mean that we believe in what we believe any less or it's any less important. But there is a certain beauty in humanity to say, you know what, I can forgive and we can move on and we can actually be human towards one another.
That's funny that you say that, because the concept of forgiveness is part of my new streaming favorite, which is Shrinking on Apple TV with Harrison Ford.
Is it good? I haven't seen it yet.
It is really good. And again, I know I'm late to it. Other people are you know, well caught up with the show by now. But again, because of the circumstances in the show, it takes a long time to get to a period of forgiveness. And it is amazingly powerful. And I will say, in my younger, more hot-headed days, something I was much less likely to either give or receive, shall we say. But I've seen enough now to understand its power more deeply than ever.
I'm hoping Steve in Milwaukee is kidding around here. He texted on the text line. He says, quote, "Screw that. If I hear one word from the in-laws, I'm going Festivus on their ass," unquote. I hope that. I honestly, Steve, I hope you're joking around. Because, I mean, if you're not, dude, I just take a breath. Because you're not going to solve the world's problems at your Thanksgiving table. And it could make things, I'm thinking your poor wife. She's married to you as her parents. You know what I mean? I mean, yes. She's caught in the middle.
Yes.
I don't know. I just.
Wait, this from the guy who showed up on my program this morning talking about a balanced Thanksgiving meal, and it was three different kinds of booze. Is that,
that it? Yeah. I mean, but there's nothing wrong with that. Oh, okay. Nothing wrong with just having. No, I started the show with a little whiskey from the distillery down here, and then went to a
Paso. No, he did not share.
A little Paso Roble, and then finished up with Disaronno and Squirt. But I mean, that's just a calming. That's medication.
That's only because we ran out of time. The keg stand was next. I mean, which by the way, that reminds me. We'll get into it later. But this is also, you ever know, this is like the new homecoming when people come back to their small towns and go to the bars there.
Yes. Oh, yeah. That's the thing in Richland Center.
Day before Thanksgiving.
Do you want to come back, Pat, or you got to go?
I can hang around.
All right, he'll be hanging around. We got one more segment with Pat. We got Trygve for the next hour and a half or so. It's a special pre-Thanksgiving edition of the Todd Allball Show right here on the Civic Media Radio Network.
As God is my witness, I thought turkeys could fly.
Amen.
You're listening to Civic Media. Stay up to date on the latest news and information for your local community and Wisconsin by signing up for our free email newsletter. Visit civicmedia.us/email to get started.
Whether it's suntanning the pontoon boat, scraping frost off the pumpkin, or putting his ice skates on in Lake Wissota, he's always on top of the news. Up North News Radio every morning from 6 until 8. Pat Kreitlow joins us here from the beautiful banks of Lake Wissota. Trygve Olson.
So ready for tomorrow's documentary on Yacht Rock on HBO.
Really?
It's going to be so good.
Yes. Oh, really? I didn't know about that. I might have to change my Thanksgiving plans.
I think you should.
Trygve Olson, senior advisor of the Lincoln Project, joins us from our nation's capital in Washington, D.C., talking a little bit about Thanksgiving and trying to, get along with folk, friends and family that we might not agree with politically a little bit. Also, what you may use to take the edge off a little bit. I mentioned one of my favorite drinks, Disaronno and Squirt. Rob, listening in Richland Center, says you can add a little orange juice to that Disaronno and Squirt as well. It's delicious. It's call it breakfast.
Well, I think we're going into full-on cocktail recipes here, but sure.
I learned this drink probably, I don't know, 15 years ago from a that's the father of my godson. It's Kurt Kohler. And you fill the glass up like a cocktail glass with ice. You put about two shots of Di Serrano and fill the rest up with Squirt. Fantastic. It's holiday in a cup.
Todd, didn't you say something about Pat sharing a recipe with us?
Yes, Pat, would you have a Martha Stewart Thanksgiving recipe you'd like to share? do you do the cooking, Pat? Because it seemed, I would think that you would not be afraid to get in the kitchen and help on Thanksgiving.
I am not the least bit afraid, and do dare say that I do most of, say, the dinner cooking.
Wow.
And I make, you know, a hot breakfast every morning. But Sherry most definitely, you know, harkens back to her farm girl roots and wants to do, you know, like Easter dinner, Thanksgiving, Christmas dinner, and other special occasions. She loves to do that. So we share the kitchen very nicely that way. Mm-hmm. If she wants me to come in and work on something, like I'll do the, you know, the green beans tomorrow, but she won't because she knows I like to make them like the firecracker green beans. And so there might be a few too many red pepper flakes in there, mm-hmm. you know, instead of just the bacon and the onion that goes in with the green beans.
Yeah.
But no, I'm very happy to do that. But most of the time it's because she works later than I do that me and my Instapot, you know, are mostly responsible. But you can't stuff a turkey in the Instapot.
No,
so, you know, I'll let Sherry take care of that tomorrow.
There's your Thanksgiving at Lake Wissota. Let me see how well I know my other co-host here today, Trygve Olson. He'll be doing Thanksgiving at the Waldorf Astoria in D.C.
No, that's not true. We go over to
the Mayflower. Oh, come Mayflower. On.
That's not true. Okay. We have some friends who are an older couple. Their kids mm-hmm. live out in California. He was the U.S. ambassador to a number of places, including places that I worked, and we have been doing Thanksgiving for like 20 years.
Well, that's cool.
Now that they're older, we make all the dinner. They make a few things.
Do you really? Look at
you.
She
makes great apple pie, and we bring it all over to their house. And
are you on Embassy Row over here? What is this? You sound like such a diplomat.
No. He is. No. He's a world. He's a man of the world, Trygve Olson.
I have a great Thanksgiving story, though, that I can tell you guys.
All right, give it to
us. So when I was living in Lithuania, mm-hmm. my wife was working for the president of Lithuania. You could not get turkeys. And this was 2001. They didn't have turkeys in Lithuania. And I happened to be in Warsaw, Poland, just before the holiday. And I had I was meeting some colleagues. They brought me the stovetop stuffing and the cranberry and whatever. And I ended up right before going to the airport, going to this hypermarket, and I found frozen turkeys. I don't know where they got the butterball turkeys in Poland, but they had them. So I had to buy a duffel bag, and I put the frozen turkey in the duffel bag, and I went to the airport. Of course, it's right after 9/11. So what I didn't realize at the Warsaw airport is that they had moved the metal detector outside and you had to go through it before you went in mm-hmm. to check your bags. And so I get up there. I've got my luggage in one bag and a frozen turkey and Thanksgiving dinner in the other. And the nice Polish military man runs it through the metal detector and he starts going, zh, 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 and he's looking. And then he gets on the phone and he's like, Lek, Lek, come here. And some other guy comes and they go, zh, zh, zh. Then they get this third guy who's clearly, I don't know, he's like a general or something. He comes over and he's looking and he says, sir, is that a dead bird in your bag? And I said, yeah, it's a turkey for Thanksgiving. And he looks at me and he's like, Thanksgiving? I have relatives in Chicago. Great holiday. Great holiday. Nice. And he's giving me a thumbs up. And then he says, are you allowed to take that into Lithuania? And I said, I don't see what business that is of yours. Isn't that between me and the Lithuanians? And he says, good point. So he waves me through. So I get into Lithuania. I go racing through customs. And I'm like, literally some ladies gibbering at me in Lithuanian to stop. And I'm just going, right? I get to the other side, and we had invited my wife's boss, the president, to come along with the ambassador and some other people to our house. And he's on the radio on that Thursday morning on a nationwide, the most popular radio show in Lithuania. And the host asks him, what are you doing today? And he tells about his day. And then he says, oh, and I'm going to my assistant has an American husband, and I'm going to my first Thanksgiving. And he smuggled the turkey in from Poland. And so I start getting all these calls from other Americans who can't get turkeys. Why didn't you invite me? And oh, by the way, did you know Palauskas told the entire world that you smuggled the turkey in? And I called my wife and I said, you tell him he's going to have to pardon me if I get arrested for smuggling the stupid turkey into Lithuania.
Oh, that's so good.
You got a hot turkey, an illegal turkey in Lithuania.
Which was already being irradiated as it was going through TSA. It was already partially cooked.
Right.
Did the story end well with a good, delicious dinner?
Yeah, it was a great Thanksgiving. It was really fun.
Well, look at that. See?
And I did not get arrested.
The president was probably on the Pat Kreitlow of Lithuania show over there.
I was going to say the Ivan Alba show over there.
Exactly. Yeah.
See, being on the radio can get people in trouble. Well, Pat, we can't thank you enough for everything you've done for this year. I'm very thankful for you, for our friendship, and we got through the election
right
together.
Back at you, buddy.
Thank you, and whenever the year comes, I'm glad we're going to be going through it together. So thank you, Pat.
Yeah. That and I'm sure it's going to be a great holiday season. Looking back and looking ahead as well. I'm looking forward to all that we'll be doing in the next month here to wrap up 2024 and then put it the hell behind us.
Yes, onward and upward.
Yeah, and then you get 2025 because
no, let's not get ahead of ourselves. I just want to get rid of this one. I'm not worried about the next one yet.
All right,
see you guys. Happy Thanksgiving.
Happy Thanksgiving, Pat. Really appreciate you. Pat Kreitlow, Up North News Radio, every morning from 6 until 8. We'll come back with Mr. Trygve Olson, talk a little bit more about how we talk to our friends and family over this Thanksgiving holiday, do a little politics as well. Your phone calls, 855-752-4842. It's the Todd Hallball Show for a pre-Thanksgiving Wednesday on the Civic Media Radio Network.
You're an organ donor, right? Well, here's a tragic fact. Approximately 20 people die each day waiting for precious donated organs. You could make a life-saving decision simply by getting that important dot on your driver's license. That little dot shows those who need to know that you've made a decision to donate organs at a critical time. Go to heroicdeed.com to learn more about the importance of organ donation and how you can make your wishes known. Talk to your family. Get the dot. Save lives. HeroicDeed.com.
Welcome back to the Todd Hallball Show on the Civic Media Radio Network. 34 now, past hour of 12 noon. Rolling out the pie dough. Getting ready to make a pumpkin pie, an apple pie perhaps. Maybe you're making dressing, stuffing. By the way, if the bird is not out of the freezer yet, you're SOL. No.
You should rectify that promptly.
The only thing, particularly
if you try and deep fry it.
Right. Yes. Don't put a.
You ever go on YouTube and check out those videos, Todd? Those
Yahoo, yes. The people that try to put a frozen turkey in a hot oil thing. It's just, you're going to burn down the house.
Yeah, it never goes well.
No. No, in all seriousness.
I actually almost started a fire in my house yesterday with the turkey.
Are you serious?
Yeah, so my daughter left the burner on the stove, and the turkey was delivered in a box, and I set the box on the stove.
Trygve.
And then I stepped outside, and I could hear a smoke detector going off, and I could hear the dog going bananas, and I opened the door, and the box was in flames.
It was in flames?
It was starting to flame up. And so I pulled the box off, threw it in the sink, and started putting it out.
Holy crap.
Smells like smoke in our house. And the thing is, Chloe the bulldog, she was on the case. She was sitting there barking at the stove. Yeah.
She was so agitated.
It was hilarious.
I had a similar thing happen at my grandma's estate sale at her house. We had ordered pizza for the people who volunteered to help us, sell everything. And so we had some pizza left, and one of the people helping to get it out of the way, put it all in the boxes and stuck the boxes in the oven just to get it out of the way. She did not know that my grandma's oven turns on if you look at it funny. It is honestly a fire hazard, and we should have gotten rid of it long ago. All of a sudden, it starts smoking and flaming. We take the boxes outside and stomp on them and run it out. There's smoke in the kitchen. And there's people trying to check out and just like angrily, like, what's taking you so long? And it's like, dude, 10 feet in front of your face, there's a flaming box of pizza. Shut up. Wait 2 minutes.
Please be careful, everyone. You do not want one of these things happening at your Thanksgiving. Trygve Olson joins us from the nation's capital, senior advisor to the Lincoln Project. Talk a little bit about Thanksgiving, how we, not just Thanksgiving, but I think after this election, Trygve, you know, there's a lot of feelings out there. And this was probably, I mean, it seems like we've said this last three elections, but the most consequential, the most just divisive election that we've had. And it's tough to try to get everybody back together around a holiday table if you come from opposite sides of the political spectrum. So you have, by the way, I want to get to a couple of texts here. Nancy from listening on Bull Falls Radio up in Wausau says, this is Nancy Stencil from Wausau. Happy Thanksgiving, Pat Kreitlow. You and Todd have a great show today. Oh, thank you very much.
I'll pass that on to Pat.
Appreciate that, Nancy. Also, Andrew in Maine of Turkey's, or Trygve's former Turkey story, smuggling a turkey into Poland, from Poland into Lithuania, says it's no wonder Trygve is not allowed in European countries anymore. Well, not all of them. He's still welcome in some. Also, Michaela in West Bend, listening on WAUK, says I'm making power systems for the Navy. Not a pie. But I got two pies. My husband and I work together from our employer, so I don't have to make anything. Worked out great for me. Well, congratulations, Michaela. We appreciate that. And thanks for all that you do for our nation's Navy as well. And also, our Hawaiian viewer on YouTube, there on the new YouTube channel, Sean, says of his Thanksgiving meal that we make our turkey in underground ovens, like the Kalua pig at a luau. Now, I have not been to Hawaii, but I've been to, a mainland Hawaiian luau type of thing. But they still did a pig underground. It's delicious. I would think a turkey would be spectacular like that. Have you had that?
I've never done that.
Really? I haven't done it. I've just tasted it when it came out of the
underground. I've had deep-fried turkey. I'm deep-frying the turkey this year. I have an indoor deep fryer.
Oh, good Lord. Are you serious? I worry about you. An indoor deep fryer for a turkey?
Yeah, you buy it from Butterball. As long as the turkey's not frozen and you get the water out of it, it'll be
fine. You couldn't handle it on the counter or the oven without lighting
it
on fire.
I didn't realize the stove. You know, it's an electric stove. I didn't see that it was on. So.
All right. Well,
deep fry. I've done it the other way. We did that same people. We did it out in the desert where it is the ones that you see on TV, because we thought if we're going to burn something down, we'll burn the Arizona desert down. But I bought an indoor turkey deep fryer. It's fantastic. It's like doing fried fish. You can do fish in it too.
Sure. Well, that's great. That's fantastic. Bring it out here. We'll have a fish fry at Lake
Minnesota. You could
have a
fish fry.
Yeah, with Pat Kreitlow next summer in the pond too.
Pat will have to catch us some walleye.
Tom up in Sauk County texted in, what I'm thankful for, the rule of law. Except for a president. Free and fair elections when MAGA wins. And fundamental rights, except for the poor others, and the Constitution, if we can keep it. A bit of tongue-in-cheek Thanksgiving list there from Tom up in Sauk County. All right, Trygve, tell us a little bit about this, because I think this is important. I think that might be people, of course, today is a big, big driving travel day. If you haven't left already, and if you're going to get on the roads now, you're probably going to run into some heavy traffic in parts of Wisconsin or elsewhere. Be patient. Just don't try to dart in and out of traffic. And we're glad that you tuned us in either via your radio or the Civic Media app. And so, Trygve, tell us a little bit about how you came to this knowledge. We're going to give people, you know, we're not professional advice givers, but I think you've have someone who is. And these are great tips, just how we can walk together in someone else's shoes for a day and try to get along.
Yeah, so I do a lot of work with the Lincoln Democracy Institute, which is our nonprofit that's really focused on research and understanding about the issue of democracy in the U.S. And I have a lot of experience from my past life in extremism and radicalization and survey work around that. And we've brought in other experts. We have a lady who's one of the leading experts on microbehaviors. And we have a woman who is an expert on sort of conversation, social psychology. Mm-hmm. And we have spent a fair amount of time in the past doing training for people before the holidays in past years about how do you have conversations with those in your life who are different, have different political persuasions. Because quite frankly, you know, we had 69% of Americans felt anxiety around the elections, and now that anxiety is turning into anxiety about having conversations with people who voted different ways over the holidays. So one of the things that's really important for people to understand is, you know, about 60% of Americans exhibit, and this is true of people on the right and left, exhibit varying degrees of political extremism. Political extremism starts with psychological distress. A lot of us are feeling that.
Yeah.
Acceptance of simplistic answers to things that tend to be complex. Overconfidence in the rightness of their opinions, and ultimately intolerance for people who don't share their political views. If you meet all four of those criteria, you would be, you know, a political extremist in terms of your political bent. Most Americans exhibit three of four. People on the left who are sort of nascent extremists tend to be more likely to be overconfident in the rightness of their answers. People on the right tend to be more likely to accept simplistic answers. So when you're getting together with people over Thanksgiving, the first thing that you have to understand is you're never going to shame somebody out of their political beliefs. You're only going to get them, hopefully, if they're extremist in their political beliefs, to look back on those views later with shame. And part of the problem that we have is, if you and I have a disagreement, Todd, I give my opinion and you give your opinion, we create a closed loop. You start locking in on yours and I lock in on mine. The key to moving people is really to be asking questions and listening and thinking. It requires what's called type one thinking, where you're using not the animal pieces of your brain, but the thinking pieces of your brain to really probe if what you, Todd, are advocating is different in ways from how I know you in other facets of your life. I want to be asking you questions that are ultimately trying to help you identify that incongruence or that cognitive dissonance. And that's not going to happen in one Thanksgiving conversation, right? Mm-hmm. You lead people to change their minds by thinking through what they're suggesting and how is that different from other aspects.
And for those of us that don't work in this stuff every day, Trygve, explain what cognitive dissonance and incongruence is, because those are kind of big words that you use in psychology types of things, but kind of, you know, as Judge Weissman from Tennessee once said, put it down there where the chickens can get at it.
Yeah, I mean, cognitive dissonance and incongruence is, you know, it's really about the differences between how they see themselves in other facets of their life, right? Mm-hmm. Like if you have a neighbor or a family member who, when your parent is sick, is bringing you casseroles, and is somebody who is active in their church and is very cognizant and aware of, you know, the plights of others, and yet is advocating for politics that doesn't conform with that, you might want to be asking them questions that lead them to see that the two are not different in that just because you know people personally versus the broader issue, what they might be advocating. An example of that would be my mom. My mom was a person who advocated lock criminals up and throw away the key until one of her former students got arrested for running a Ponzi scheme and got 20 years, and suddenly it was personal. And she's like, he's never going to have an opportunity to make right. And he's a good person. He did something wrong. There should be some forgiveness. And I said, but Mom, do you understand where what you're saying when it's somebody you know is very different from what you say when it's people you don't know? Mm-hmm. And it was constantly about trying to get her to see the difference, mm-hmm. if that makes sense.
It does. And
it's
and,
always different when you know somebody personally.
Right.
You have to get people to see that somebody else has family members. You know, those yeah. people that she was advocating throw away the key, they had family members who felt like she did about her former student.
Yeah. My former boss, Dale Schultz, was fond of saying, you know, people don't care how much you know until they know how much you care. And I think there's right. a lot to that. I'm so glad we're doing this, Trygve, because we kind of goof around and talk, you know, a lot about a lot of different things. This is you have great insight into this, and I'm glad you're bringing this to the program. And I hope people call in and ask questions. 855-752-4842, 855-752-4842. And I'll just, I've shared it in different forms, but you said this on the show last week, you know, that you can never shame someone into changing their political beliefs. And I applied it to myself. And the question I would ask a lot of our friends on the left is, have you, or how many people you know, distinctly changed their voting pattern or their party affiliation for all practical purposes? I basically have. I would, you know, people that know me from Richland Center know that I was a dyed-in-the-wool, straight-ticket Republican from the time I voted for George H.W. Bush in 1988 until 2011. And the reason I changed wasn't because somebody on the left was yelling at me or shaming me or telling me I was a terrible person, although those things happened. And all it did, Trygve, was actually probably harden me to my original party. What changed right. my thinking was seeing, I had the unique opportunity of seeing firsthand people from our party trying to take voting rights away from Black, brown people and students. And I applied that to what in my heart, is that right? And I said, no, that's not right. And I can no longer support a party that doesn't do or support what I know in my heart is right. I mean, is that an example of incongruence?
Yeah, 100%. I mean, that's you coming to that realization. Mm-hmm. And you still probably, on a lot of issues, are conservative and
sure.
back
I mean,
Republican position.
Yeah, some of them, yeah. We're going to come back and talk about more about this. Take your phone calls as well. Trygve Olson with us for all 2 hours on a pre-Thanksgiving Day special on the Civic Media Radio Network.
You're listening to Civic Media. Find the latest news, information, and archives of all your favorite shows on the Civic Media website, civicmedia.us.
Welcome back to the Todd Allball Show, a pre-Thanksgiving special edition. We are live here high atop State Street, a block off the Capitol Square in downtown Madison, Wisconsin. Zommer's on the board spinning the Thanksgiving tunes. And Trygve Olson out in our nation's capital of Washington, D.C., a former Republican like myself, a River Falls native, and now a senior advisor at the Lincoln Project, talking a little bit about, I mean, this is great stuff, Trygve, because you've had so much experience with this, not just in the United States, but around the world. You've seen it work. You've seen it when people don't follow these rules, literally countries can get overthrown. And when it doesn't work, and I think this is on a smaller scale for each of us, it gives us really good knowledge for this weekend, as we're going to maybe be in situations where we're with people that don't agree with us. And I think this key point that you've made now for 2 weeks is you cannot shame people into changing their political beliefs. Tony watching on YouTube says, I changed parties after Trump got the nomination in 2015 and did a pretty big 180. But before the break, you were talking about this as cognitive dissonance, this taking what you see and hear as fact and applying it to your own values. And that's really when you get people to change.
Yeah, and I think, you know, as it relates to people in the holidays and seeing family, they're your family, right? Mm-hmm. Like, they're the only family you got. And in some cases, they're family by choice, if they're your in-laws. And in some cases, you know, your parents, you don't really have a choice. And you have to decide. I mean, if you're just planning on and wanting to have a fight and somehow that gives you some form of self validation, like, but it isn't going to probably make you feel better about yourself or your family. If anything, it's just going to depress you more about some of the where things are headed. So you have to say to yourself, if you want to be constructive, you need to try and understand them as people you care about. And if you take it out of the political, if you had a family member who was having some issues, right, you'd want to be asking them questions. I mean, everybody with family has probably had people who are going through a hard time. You wouldn't be lecturing them. You would be questioning, trying to understand, maybe giving them some counsel or trying to point out differences, different perspectives. That really, and get them to be thinking about different perspectives, not even pointing them out, but trying to get them to see them within themselves. And that really is what you have to be doing in this particular case. And, you know, it's not like either side has a monopoly. I would guess that there are people on the right who are thinking, oh my God, that kid's going to be home from college and I'm going to have to listen to them and what do they know? And, you know, lacking into the intolerance side rather than trying to understand their perspective and find common ground. Because the truth of the matter is there's far more we agree on than we disagree on.
Yeah, agree. Lots of calls and texts coming in. We're going to get to, we're coming up on the break here at the top of the hour, but we will pick it up. Trygve stay with us the whole show. So we're going to get to all these calls and texts. Right now, I want to go to the phone line. Bob in Waukesha calling in. Bob, thanks for listening down there in beautiful Waukesha. Happy pre-Thanksgiving to you. And what do you have for us?
Well, thank you. And I enjoy your show.
Thank you so much.
Right now, I am just disgusted with our country. The Republican Party is no better than the mafia. They don't kill you, but they take away all your rights. And Trump is getting away with the insurrection. He's getting away with the phone call he made to Georgia looking for 11,750 votes. But yet, if some felon doesn't know that he can't vote after he served his time, he can get in big trouble. But Trump, and then you've got Ron Johnson, the slate of 17 false electors here in Wisconsin, and our attorney general won't do nothing, won't punish them. But yet, if I vote twice, he throw me in jail. There's right is wrong and wrong is right with this Republican Party right now. They have no integrity, no honesty. They are nothing but they're in cahoots with Trump. And he's like their God. He runs them. And our laws be damned.
Bob, before we run out of time, I see it in the notes here. It says you're a Vietnam vet. So first of all, thank you very much for your service to our country. Really, really, really appreciate everything that you and all those in that war did for our country. So thank you for that. I hear you.
Thank you.
My pleasure. And Trey, we only got about a couple of minutes here. We can pick it up on the other side. But I'm so appreciative of this call from Bob. Because a lot of people I'm hearing this from is despair that how, you know, we find out a couple of days ago, Jack Smith drops all these charges, you know, on what Trump did in terms of trying to overthrow the election. And there's a lot of despair to Bob's point. If we would have done any of these things, we would have had our rear ends in jail. What do we say to these folks, all of us who feel this despair?
Well, I mean, you know, obviously Bob being a Vietnam vet knows that, you know, 68, 69, those were trying times in the United States, divisive times. And we've had other moments in our history where we have had serious divides and we have found the way through them. Remember, you know, the founding document is we the people in order to form a more perfect union. We have lots of people on the right who love to talk about we the people, we the people. But what they miss is we the people in order to form a more perfect union. The American experiment is an ongoing process. It's a dream, and it's up to us to figure out the way through that. And that starts with people being able to have conversations with each other, particularly with family.
We're going to come back, talk more about that. And thanks a lot, Bob. Appreciate it. I'm hoping the guardrails of the Constitution hold. Come back, hour two with Trygve and more after this on the Civic Media Radio Network.
The national news cycle never stops, but it can be hard to find news about your local community. Civic Media is dedicated to providing quality local and state news coverage across Wisconsin. With the Civic Media app, you can get notifications about local stories that matter to you and your community. Find the free Civic Media app in your phone's app store and choose notifications from the menu to tell us what kind of news you want to hear about.